బయట. రైట్, క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 31. Q1. Without stoppages, the train travels certain distance with average speed of 60 km/h, and with stoppages, it covers the same distance with an average speed 40 km/h. How many minutes per hour does the train stop? Right. Difference of speeds by maximum speed. Difference of speeds by maximum speed. Hours converts to minutes. What is Q1? Q1. 20. Next, two types undertake to do a job. Second type is begin after 1 hour after the first. 3 hours after first typist has begun working, there is still 9/20 of the work to be done. In the sense, completed work is 11/20. When the assignment is completed, it turns out that each typist has done half of the work. How many hours would it take to each one of to do it individually? Right. So, you know Q1, which is 20. Let's say we have two persons, A and B. A started after 1 hour, B started. They completed 11/20 of the work. After how many hours? After 3 hours. So, A already worked for 3 hours. As B started after 1 hour, B worked for only 2 hours. As B started after 1 hour, when they complete the work, the difference of time taken, the difference of work time, the difference of time A worked and B worked should be 1 hour. Let me repeat the same here. Let's say A worked for 3 hours, B also worked for 2 hours. Then again they'll be working, they'll be completing 11/20 of the work. What is total work done so far? 11/20 plus 11/20. 22/20. Right. How many hours of A work we have?
3 hours.
And B?
4 hours.
4 hours together. But there should be only 1 hour difference, right?
Yes.
So how much extra work is done we have with respect to A?
1 hour.
We have extra 1 hour work of A, and which is equal to 2/20. Here we have 3 hours work of A, which is equal to 6/20. Out of 11/20, if 6/20 is done by A, remaining 5/20 is done by B? Yes or no? Right. So, A in 3 hours completed 6/20 of work, and B in 2 hours completed 5/20 of the work. Then total work can be done by A in 10 hours. 3 hours, 6 units, 20 units, how many hours?
10 hours.
A, B iddaru unnaru. ఈయన 3 hours చేశారు, ఈయన 2 hours చేశారు, కలిపి 11/20 అవర్ కంప్లీట్ అయింది. ఫస్ట్ 1 hour ఏ ఒక్కడే చేశాడు, తర్వాత ఇద్దరు కలిపి చేస్తూ ఉన్నారు. ఆఫ్టర్ ఫస్ట్ అవర్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద టైమ్ వీ హ్యావ్, బోత్ ఏ అండ్ బి విల్ బీ వర్కింగ్ టుగెదర్. బట్ ఐ వాంట్ టు రిపీట్ ద కేస్. ఐ నో దెర్ ఈస్ ఎ ఎక్స్ట్రా 1 hour ఫర్ ఏ, బట్ ఐ వాంట్ టు రిపీట్ ద సేమ్. Then you will have 3 hours here and 2 hours here. Again 11/20 of work is done. So here how much extra work of A we have? And total together 11/20 and 11/20, how much extra work we have? 2/20. 2/20 in the sense 1/10. So A can complete 1/10 of work in how many hours? In how many hours? Then total work can be done by A in how many hours? 10 hours. Right? Now let's take B. In first case, you know that 3 hours work of A and 2 hours work of B is equal to 11 by 20th. What do you mean by 3 hours work of A? 3 by 10? Yes or no? 3 by 10 also can be written as 6 by 20. 6 by 20 plus how much will give you 11 by 20? 5 by 20. 5 by 20th in the sense 1/4? So 1/4 of work is done by B in how many hours? Come on. So 1/4 work is done by B in 2 hours. Then total work can be done by B in how many hours? Over. You cannot get the answer because in Q2 you have individual times taken by A and B. You will have two values. It cannot be Q2. Idi edana mamulu aptitude question lo ivali. What are individual number of hours taken by A and B? Answer should be 10, 8. Okay, next. 32. Q1. A dog after traveling 50 kilometers meets a swami who counsels him to go slower. He then proceeds at 3/4 of his former speed and arrives destination 35 minutes late. Had the meeting occurred 24 kilometers further, the dog would have reached its destination 25 minutes late. The speed of the dog is right. Let's say meeting happened here and this is the destination. In first case, what is the extra time taken? 35 minutes. In the second case, meeting happened 24 kilometers further. Now, to reach destination, it is taking only 25 minutes. In all the cases, in both the cases, the speed becomes only 3/4. Yes or no? Right. So here, let me take 24 kilometers in the first case. First case, first 24 kilometers is covered with 3/4 speed. Yes or no?
Yes.
Second case, first 24 kilometers is traveled with original speed, but the remaining distance is covered with 3/4 speed. Yes or no? Ardhamavutunda? Right. Now, speed differences ekkada unnayante first 24 kilometers lone undi. First 24 kilometers here is traveled with 3/4 speed and here it is traveling with original speed. What is the speed decrease? 1/4. If speed decreases by 1/4, time should increase by 1/3. For always increase of 1 by x, there should be decrease of 1 by x plus 1. As speed decreases by 1/4, time should increase by? Right. What is the extra time taken in first case than in second case? 10 minutes. So 1/3 is equal to 10. Then 1 is equal to 30. Are you getting? So to cover 24 kilometers, if it takes 30 minutes, you're asked about speed in kilometer per hour. Hour in the sense, 60 minutes. In 60 minutes, it can cover 48 kilometers. యాక్చువల్గా ఏం లేదు క్వశ్చన్లో, మీకు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేయడానికి టైం పడుతుంది కానీ ఐఎమ్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ ఓన్లీ 24 కిలోమీటర్స్. ఫస్ట్ కేస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ మూవింగ్ విత్ 3/4 స్పీడ్ అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ కేస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ మూవింగ్ విత్ ఒరిజినల్ స్పీడ్ 24 కిలోమీటర్స్. ఎక్స్ట్రా టైమ్ టేకెన్ ఇన్ ఫస్ట్ కేస్ ఈస్ 35 మినిట్స్ అండ్ ఎక్స్ట్రా టైమ్ టేకెన్ ఇన్ సెకండ్ కేస్ ఈస్ 25 మినిట్స్. దట్ ఈస్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ 24 కిలోమీటర్స్ ఓన్లీ. How much extra time we have in first case? 10 minutes. If speed decreases here, from second case to first case, if speed decreases, obviously time decreases. Speed decreases by 1/4. Time increases by 1/3. So 1/3 time is equal to 10 minutes, then total time is equal to 30 minutes. Total time is 30 minutes to cover how many kilometers? 24 kilometers. 30 minutes in this half an hour. In half an hour, if it can cover 24 kilometers, in 1 hour it can cover 48 kilometers. So Q1 is equal to 48. Next. In a race of 600 meters, Ajay beats Vijay by 60 meters. Can I say 10%? Right. In a race of 500 meters, Vijay beats Anjay by 25 meters. Can I say 5%? Yes? Right. By how many meters will Ajay beat Anjay in a 400 meters race? Right. It's a 400 meters race. Beats ante, first of all, see, you should understand the first case. Ajay beats Vijay by 60 meters in a race of 600 meters. In the sense, Ajay should cover 600 meters and Vijay will be 60 meters behind. That means 540. Yes or no? Yavaraithe beat chestunnaro vallu destination ki reach avvali. Are you getting? Right. Ippudu iddaru race ikkadi nunchi start chesaru. Meeru mee friend. Meeru first ikkadiki vellipoyaru. Meeru vellipoyina tarvata enakuntadu mee friend. మీ ఇద్దరికి మధ్యలో 50 meters గ్యాప్ ఉంది. అప్పుడు మీ ఫ్రెండ్ కంటే మీరు 50 meters ఎక్స్ట్రాగా ట్రావెల్ చేసినట్టు. ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? సో ఫస్ట్ యూ షుడ్ రీచ్ ద ఫినిష్ లైన్, దెన్ యువర్ ఫ్రెండ్ విల్ బి 50 meters బిహైండ్ యూ. సో ఇన్ ద సేమ్ కేస్, నావ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ క్వశ్చన్ అబౌట్ 400 meters రేస్. ఇన్ హౌ మెనీ, బై హౌ మెనీ మీటర్స్ అజయ్ కెన్ బీట్ అంజయ్? సో యూ హ్యావ్ నో రిలేషన్ బిట్వీన్ అజయ్ and Vijay, and then Vijay and Anjay. Now, if Ajay is here, who already covered 400 meters, Vijay will be covering what percentage less than Ajay? Come on. What percentage less than Ajay? I told you already here. In 600 meters, Vijay will be 60 meters behind. In the sense, what percent?
10%.
Now in a race of 500 meters, Vijay beat Anjay by what percentage? 5%. Right. Now, this is a race about 400 meters and Ajay is at finish line. Vijay will be covering what percent less than distance covered by Ajay? Come on. 10% of 400? Then Vijay will be covering how many meters? 360. Now, Anjay will be covering what percentage of the distance covered by Vijay?
5%.
What is 5% of this number? 18. 18 less than 360? 342. What is distance difference between Ajay and Anjay now? 50. That's it. From here to here it is 10% less. And from here to here it is 5%. Basically you need not even calculate this number. You know the difference here will be 40 and 5% of 360 is 18. Add both the numbers, you will get 58. What was Q1? Q1 less than Q2? Next. Two pipes A, B can fill a cistern in 10 minutes and 15 minutes respectively. Both pipes are open, but at the end of 3 minutes, B is turned off. How much total time will it take the end of 3 minutes? Right. How much time will the cistern take to fill? Now, tap B is open for how many minutes? Come on. 3 minutes. In 3 minutes, it will cover 20% of the tank. What is the total time taken by tab B to fill the tank? 15 minutes. If it worked for 3 minutes, what percentage of the tank is filled? 20%. Then remaining 80% is filled by? Tab A takes how much time to fill 80% of the tank? 10 minutes. Na question correct. Tap A takes how much time to fill 80% of the tank?
8 minutes.
Tap A is the one which is opened from the beginning till completion of the work. So if tap A is opened for 8 minutes, The time to fill the tank is also 8 minutes. Q1, 8 minutes. ఏమి లేదబ్బా దానిలో? Solve it, you'll get x is equal to 8. Tap A takes 10 minutes to fill the tank. 1 minute work of tap A is equal to 1 by 10. Tap A worked for x minutes. X minutes work of tap A is equal to x by 10. Tap B can fill the tank in 15 minutes. 1 minute work is equal to 1 by 15. Tap B opened for 3 minutes. 3 minutes work is equal to 3 by 15. Both the taps open together to fill the tank is equal to 1. Solve it, you will get x is equal to 8. Ila equation yes chepta inka meek ave correct. Vijay has some 50 paisa coins, some 2 rupee coins, some 1 rupee coins and 5 rupee coins. The value of all the coins is 50. Number of 2 rupee coins is 5 more than 5 rupee coins. 50 paisa coins are double the number of, are double in number than 1 rupee coins, and the sum is 26. How many 2 rupee coins does he have? Right. I don't want everything. What is total money that we have? 50. Out of 50, amount of 50 paisa and 1 rupee coins together is 26. Then remaining money? Remaining money? 24. So 24 rupees is sum of amount collected from 2 rupee coins and 5 rupee coins. Yes or no? Right. So total money of 2 rupee and 5 rupee coins together is equal to 24. Now number of 2 rupee coins is 5 more than number of 5 rupee coins. If 5 rupee coins are x, then 2 rupee coins are x plus 5. Correct? Now 7x plus 10 is equal to 24. 7x is equal to 14. X is equal to 2. But you're asked about number of 2 rupee coins, which is x plus 5, which is 7. Q2 is 7. What was Q1? Q1 more than Q2. Pradeep and Kishan together can complete typing work, a book of 1008 pages in 12 days, working 7 hours per day. Pradeep is 25% more efficient than Kishan. A page contains an average of 333 words. How many words can Pradeep type in 1 hour? Okay. Right. Now your question is about number of words. Let's say whether it is about Pradeep or Krishan or together or difference, whatever it is, a bit later, but concentrate only on number of words a book has. Yes? Book has how many pages? 1008. And each page has how many words? 333. Right. So these many number of words are done in how many days and how many hours per day? 12 days and 7 hours per day. Right. By 12 into 7. Will it give you number of words that typed in 1 hour? Yes or no? Right. Now concentrate on Pradeep and Kishan. Pradeep's efficiency is 25% more than Kishan's efficiency. So if Kishan's efficiency was 100%, then Pradeep's becomes 125%. Can I take this as 5 is to 4? Together we'll be doing how many parts? So these number of words are for 9 parts, right? Now your question is about Pradeep. Pradeep will be doing work with what parts? How many parts? 5 parts. 5 parts is equal to how much? Let's go for first cancellation here, then we can do it. 7, cancellation with 7, 28. 7 ones, 7 fours, again 4, 12 how many times? 12 times, right? Can we also write this number as 12 as 3 into 4? 333 as 3 into 111?
Yes.
So I can write as 9 into 4 into 111, that becomes 444.
Yes.
If 9 parts is equal to 9 into 444, 5 parts will be equal to 5 into 444.
Yes.
5 into 444 in the sense 2220. Take 10 times and make it half. 10 times of this number, 4410. But we need only 5 times, which is half of 10 times. 4440 and half of that 2220. Clear? Next. So what was Q1? 2220. Next. A certain amount of money gets 4 times of its original amount after 24 years at a simple interest. What will be the interest on a sum of 8500 compound interest annually at the same rate after 2 years? Right. See, a certain amount of money gets 4 times of itself. If you give me 100%, I have to give you what percent? In the sense, how much percentage of interest I have added? 300% interest. In how many years? In how many years? 24 years. So 300% interest is obtained in 24 years. Per year is equal to how much? I want to calculate. So can I go for cancellation with 6? 50 times? 4 times. In the sense, 12.5%? Yes or no? Right. Now rate of interest is 12.5%. You are asked to calculate compound interest on 8500 after 2 years. Can we take 12.5% as 1/8? Yes or no?
Yes.
Now principal is 8500. Now we need to calculate compound interest for how many years? 2 years. What is 1/8 of this number? 1/8 of this number? 1 0 6. Two. I don't care what it is. Enough. Second year also we will get 1062 plus 1/8 of this number? Yes or no? Wait a minute. All this is about Q1, Q2 comparison? You know Q1 how much is that? 2220. Already we got 2120. Yes or no? And 1/8 of this number, come on. 1/8. 1 3. I guess this is enough.
Yes.
I guess this is enough.
Yes,
yes or no?
Yes.
So what can be concluded? Q1
less than
Q2. Done. You know that Q1 is 2220. Here we know that this value is more than 2220. Ratio of percentages of son and daughter of a lady is in the ratio 7:8, and the age of the lady is 7 of total ages of her daughter and son. Okay. If the ratio of ages of son after 1 year, after 3 years, and the age of the daughter 6 years ago is 4:3. Then what will be the ratio of present ages of a lady and her son after 4 years? Right. Evaru icharu, son and daughter. 7:8. Okay. son, daughter, mother. Son age to daughter age ratio is given as 7:8, and you also given that mother age is equal to sum of son age and daughter age. So that should be equal to how many parts? Ma? 15 parts. Next, first line is over. Ratio of ages of son after 3 years and age of daughter 6 years ago is 4:3. Then what will be the ratio of present ages of lady, age of her son after 4 years? Son age after 3 years, that is 7 parts plus 3. Daughter age 6 years ago. Ratio is given as 4:3. I can write as 4/3. Come on. Right. So 7 3s 21, 8 4s 32. 32, 21 difference 11 parts. 6 into 4 minus 24, 3 into 3 9. 9 plus 24 33. If 11 parts is equal to 33, 1 part is equal to 3. Then 7 parts 21, 15 parts 45. You're asked about ratio between present age of lady and son age after 4 years. Lady present age 45, son present age 21, after 4 years 25. Ratio 9:5. Next, two trains, one from a place A and B, another from B to A. And kaadi idi two trains, one from place A to B, another from B to A, started simultaneously. They meet. After they meet, they reach their destination after 21.25 hours, 12.25 hours, 17.64 hours respectively. The ratio of their speeds is right. After passing each other, this is the major condition. After they meet, they are taking these many number of hours, right? So here for this question, after passing each other, if you have this condition in problems on trains, S1 by S2 is equal to under root of T2 by T1. This is the direct formula. Remember, this condition is very important. After passing each other. So here you are given time, which is 12.25. We can take it as 12:25. The other one, 17:64. 17:64 is which number square? Which number square? 42 square. And 12:25? 35 square. Ratio is cancellation with 7. 7 6 times, 5 times. Speed ratio 6:5. Remember, it is T2 by T1. So what was Q1 we got? 9:5. Q2? So Q1? More than Q2. You can take 9:5 as 9/5 and 6:5 as 6/5. 9/5 more than 6/5. Meeku ichina condition entante Q2 lo, if this is A is moving towards B and the other is moving from B to A. Let's say they met here at this particular point. After they meet each other at this particular point, the first is taking 12.25 hours to reach destination, And from here, second train is taking 17.64 minutes. From here, not from the beginning to the ending. After meeting point, from here they are taking these many number of hours or minutes time to reach their respective destinations. So that is what the important point. After passing each other. After passing. In that case, S1 by S2 is equal to under root of T2 by T1. Usually they will give you the time taken by first train from A to B and from B to A. But this is after passing. Okay? Next. Quadratic? Sure? 38 answer? This is minus, right? Exponent. C value negative here. C value also negative here. Both are negative. Relation cannot be established. Right. A rectangular plot 24 meters long and 16 meters wide has two concrete crossroads running in the middle of it. One parallel to length, other parallel to breadth. The rest of the plot is used for gardening. If the area used for gardening is 240 square meters, what is the width of the road? Right. So, total plot area should be equal to road area plus gardening area. Plot area in the sense 24 into 16. Usual measurements. Matladaru. And that should be equal to gardening area, which is 240 plus. Suppose if these are your measurements, if you have a road like this whose width is x, road area will be 24 minus x, correct? And this one also, if width is x, that becomes 16 minus x, correct? Now, so here you'll have something, road area. But my point is, this is 4 multiple. Matladaru.
Yes,
this is also 4 multiple.
Yes.
Together is 16 multiple.
Yes.
This is also 16 multiple.
Yes.
Then this must be also 16 multiple. Matladaru.
Yes.
So are given numbers 4 multiples?
Yes.
From 4 multiples, if you subtract only 4 multiple, then only it will be 4 multiple. Then road area, road width also should be 4 multiple. Look at your options. Over. Got it? Done. Next. The respective ratio between percentages of P and Q is 7:4. Respect to ratio between P's age 2 years hence, Q's age 6 years ago. P's percentage from the ratio? 7 parts. And Q? 4 parts. P's age 2 years hence? 7 parts plus 2. Q's age 6 years ago? 4 parts minus 6 is equal to 3 by 1. What is the respective ratio between P's age 4 years ago? Q says 12 years hence. Right, we'll see that later. Come on. 7 parts into 1? 7 parts. 4 parts into 3? 12 parts. Difference? 5 parts. 6 into 3? Minus 18. 2 into 1? 2. Minus 18 comes to left hand side, becomes plus 18. 18 plus 2? 20. 5 parts is equal to? 20. Then percentage of P is 7 parts, which is equal to? 5, how many times is 20? 4 times. 7 fours? 28. Q's percentage 4 parts, which is equal to 4 fours? 16. Now let's see your question. You're asked to calculate ratio between P's age 4 years ago. P's percentage is 28. 4 years back? 24. Q's age 12 years hence. Percentage of Q? Percentage of Q? 16. After 12 years? 28. Cancellation with 4, 6 times, 7 times. Second option. jar had a certain quantity of water, to which pure milk of thrice the quantity of water was added. 16 liters of this mixture from the jar was taken out and replaced with 8 liters of pure milk, as a result of which water constituted 20% of the resulting mixture. What was the initial quantity of water in the jar? Right. Let's say initially we have one part water. One part. How many parts of milk added?
Three parts.
What is total quantity now?
Four parts.
Right. From four parts, how many liters is taken out?
Three.
After that, again, how many liters of how many liters added? What is final effect?
8 liters
gone. 16 liters taken out, but after that 8 liters added, finally 8 liters gone. So now what is the quantity? 4 parts minus 8. Initially we have 4 parts, but final result 8 liters taken out. So now the quantity is 4 parts minus 8. In that, what is water percentage?
20%.
Then remaining will be
80%.
20%, 80% ratio. 1 is to 4. Total should be what multiple? Right. Now, you know that total you have 4 parts. From that, 8 liters is taken out. Finally, that should be a multiple of 5. Correct? Now, what is your question about? Total quantity initially, or total milk in the initial container, or total water in initial container? Which is your question? Water in initial container in terms of number of parts? How many parts? Right, substitute. You need to calculate only one part here. See, if one part is equal to 8, what about four parts? Verify this condition. Four parts minus 8. Will that be a 5 multiple if you take first option? Now, if one part is equal to 10, 4 parts minus 8, will that be 5 multiple?
No.
If one part is equal to 16, 4 parts minus 8, will that be 5 multiple? If one part is equal to 24, 4 parts minus 8, will that be 5 multiple?
No.
Got it? Otherwise, you have to use equation, which I don't prefer. Come on, next. Cars M and N started at the same time from place A and B respectively. They travel towards each other at 34 km per hour and 48 km per hour. See, both are moving in which direction? Opposite direction. When these cars met, it was found that one car has traveled 119 km more than the other. See, first car is moving with what speed? And second?
48.
So second car's speed is 14 kilometers more than the first car?
Yes.
So in 1 hour, second car can cover 14 kilometers more than first car?
Yes.
But when they met, it has observed that one of the car has had covered 119 extra kilometers. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right. In 1 hour, second car can cover how many extra kilometers?
14.
But to cover extra 119 kilometers, it takes 119 by 14 hours time? Yes or no? If both are moving opposite to each other, first of all, what is this? I don't want number expressed in words. What is that? Time. So if both covered for 1 hour, second car can cover 14 extra kilometers, but they have covered already 119 extra kilometers. For that, how much time it is required? 119 by 14. But you're asked about distance. Distance is equal to speed into time, where you already know the time, but need to calculate speed. When both are moving opposite to each other, relative speed becomes S1 plus S2. S1 plus S2, how much?
82.
7. 2 times 7, 17 times. to 41 times. So finally 17 into 41, answer should end with 7. 7 into 1 should end with 7, only 1. A and B started a business by investing 8,000, 10,000. After 4 months, C joined them by investing 9,000. After 2 months of C's joining, A and B withdraws half of their... A and B started, C joined with 9,000. After 2 months of C's joining, A and B withdraws half of their respective initial respective investments. If they earn annual profit of 31,200, what is B's share of annual profit? Right. 8,000, 10,000 and then 9,000. When did C join? After 4 months. See, after 2 months of C's joining, A and B withdraws half of their investments. Yes or no? Right. In the sense, 6 months, their initial investments of A and B will be as it is. After that, as they withdraw half of their investments, 4 parts and 5 parts will be there for remaining 6 months. As C joined after 4 months, investment will be only for 8 months. Everywhere you have 6 common, take 6 common and go for cancellation. 6 multiple are 3 multiple and 2 multiple, one and the same? 3 threes, 2 fours. Now it is 8 plus 4, 12, 10 plus 5, 15, 3 fours, 12. Again it becomes 4 parts, 5 parts, 4 parts. Total? Total? 13 parts is equal to 31,000, sorry. Annual profit 31,000. 200, B's share, 5 parts, is equal to how much? 13 how many times? 13 twos, 4 times, double 0. 2400, 5 times, take 10 times and make it half? Answer? 12,000. Come on. Naina purchased 15 kgs of rice at the rate of 32 rupees per kg, another 25 kgs of rice at sudden rate. She mixed two quantities and sold the entire quantity at 34.2 rupees per kg and made 20% overall profit. See, by selling it for 34.2, there is a profit of 20%, but you must take only cost price. Selling price is 120%, cost price is 100%. Can I take this as 6 parts and this as 5 parts?
Yes.
Right. After selling quantity at 34.2 rupees, there is a profit of 20%. Yes or no?
Yes.
So 6 parts is equal to 34.2. Correct? 6 how many times? 5.7 times. 5.7 times? Take 10 times and make it half, 57, half of that, 28.5. So mixer cost price is 28.5. Mixer cost price is 28.5. You know cost price of first variety, how much is cost price of first variety? 32 rupees. You need to calculate second variety cost price. You know both the quantities are in what ratio? 15 kgs and 25 kgs ratio 3:5. So here it will be 3 parts and here it will be 5 parts. Difference between 32 and 28.5, how much is that? 3.5. 5 how many times is 3.5? 0.7. 3.7 times? 2.1. So how much is this number? 28.5 minus 2.1. How much is that? 26.4. In allegation, you know that this number should be more than one of the number and less than another number. As 28.5 is less than already 32, it has to be more than this number. Hence, this should be less than 28.5. By how much? 2.1. 28.5 minus 2.1, 26.4. Next, a boat takes 15 hours to travel 120 kilometers upstream. So what is upstream speed? 120 by 15, which is 8 kilometer per hour. Next, the speed of the same boat upstream is half of that same boat downstream. Then downstream speed will be 16 kilometer per hour, correct? How much time will the boat take to cover 100 kilometers downstream? 100 kilometers downstream. Downstream speed 16. How much is that? 6 hours and something will be there? That is the option where we have 6 hours and apart from that something else is there. Clear? ఇది ఎంత అనేది కూడా మీకు సంబంధం లేదు. 6 hours తర్వాత ఇంకొంచెం వస్తుంది. ఆ 6 తర్వాత ఇంకొంచెం ఉన్నది, ఇది ఒక్కటే కదా. ఆ కొంచెం ఎంత అయితే మీకేంటి? నెక్స్ట్, అభి ఇన్వెస్టెడ్ ఏ సడన్ అమౌంట్ ఎక్స్ రూపీస్ ఇన్ స్కీమ్ ఏ, లెట్ ఇట్ బి 100%. ఇన్ స్కీమ్ ఏ ఆఫరింగ్ సింపుల్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఎట్ 12% పర్ యానం ఫర్ 4 ఇయర్స్. హౌ మచ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ యూ విల్ గెట్? 48% అండ్ 2x రూపీస్. 2x ఇన్ ద సెన్స్ వాట్ పర్సెంట్? 200% in scheme B, compound interest at the rate of 10% per annum for 2 years, that will be 21%. 21% of this number? 42%. What is difference here? 6%, which is equal to 207. Difference between interest he earned from both the schemes is 207. How much did he invest in scheme A, which is 100%? 6 how many times? 3 times, 4 times, 0.5 times. 134.5 times, 3,450. A started a business. After 4 months from the start of the business, B and C joined. Respective ratio of amounts of investments made by ABC was 6:11:12. If C's share in the annual profit was 720 more than A's share, what was total annual profit earned? Right. A, B, C invested these many rupees. After 4 months from the start of the business, B and C joined. So A will be there for 12 months, B and C will be there for 8 months. Cancellation with 8, 8, 4, 3 times, 2, 3 times. Cancellation with 8 or 4 and 2? 9 parts, 11 parts, 12 parts. Total, 32 parts. Difference between A's share and C's share? 3 parts. 3 parts is equal to 720. 32 parts is equal to how much? As 720 has 10, here also you should have 10. 3 into which number ends with 2? 4. 4 into 2 ends with 8. Answer should end with 80. $720 has 0, here also you will get 10. 3 into which number ends with 2? 4. 2 into 4 ends with 8. Answer should end with 80. Last digit verification. Got it? So this is direct theorem. If this value is x degrees, here it should be 2x degrees. A triangle's property lo untadi. Right, any other question here? Anybody? Sure? Table 52. Any other apart from 52? 54, right. Average number of jackets sold by store B in 2006 and 7 is 430. Average number of jackets sold by F in 2006 and 7, 183. What is the difference between number of jackets sold by B and F in 2007? Right. B and F. See, if average is 430, total 860. If average is 183, total 366. Right. So 860 is both in 2006 and 7, 2 years together. Now you have information about 2006. In 2006, B made 18%. 18% of what? 2500. What is 20%? 500. What is 2%? 50. That means 450. Total it is 860. Already you have 450. Then balance 410 in 2007. F is 10%. 10% of 2500? 250. Total it is 366. Already you have 250. The other one? 116. You are just asked about difference between 410 and 116. How much? 294. Answer should end with 4. Clear? Next, somebody asked 54. Number of jackets sold by D increased by 30% from 6 to 7 and decreased by 20% from 7 to 8. What was the number of jackets sold by D in 2008? 100, 130, 104, 104. Right. D kada? D is what percent here? 20% of 2500 is 500. First increase by 30%. It becomes 650. Again decreased by 20%. 20% of 650 is 130. Becomes 520. Clear? చలిగేది డైరెక్ట్గానే చెప్పేచ్చు ఇందాకే వస్తుంది. యూ నీడ్ నాట్ నంబర్ యాక్చువల్లీ. ఇనీషియల్ ఇట్ ఈస్ 100%, ఆఫ్టర్ దాట్ ఇట్ బికమ్స్ 130%, అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ దాట్ ఇట్ బికమ్స్ 104%. విచ్ నంబర్ ఈజ్ 104 మల్టిపుల్? దిస్ వన్. 104 5 టైమ్స్ డైరెక్ట్. నెక్స్ట్ టేబుల్ ఎనీ పర్టికులర్ క్వశ్చన్? 56. If in company A, 128 female or non-gazetted employees, what percent of female are gazetted employees? Total employees, number of non-gazetted employees. Okay. Out of total number of gazetted employees, percentage of gazetted employees. Fine. Now, see here, in company A we have total 1200 members, 240 are non-gazetted, then gazetted employees are 960. Out of 960, 40% are female. What about 10%? 96. Can I take 96 as 4 less than 100? 40% will be 16 less than 400? 16 less than 400? 3. 384 are gazetted or non-gazetted? Gazetted employees. Gazetted female. And 128 are non-gazetted. 128, non-gazetted. And gazetted female are this much. And what is your question? What percent female are gazetted employees? What about total employees now? Total employees, 512. Out of 512, gazetted female are what percentage? 384 out of 512 into 100. That is 3/4, right? Yes or no? 3/4 in the sense what percent? 75%. Got it? See, what is this 2 to the power of? 6. What is this 2 to the power of? 8. 2 to the power of 6 into 4 will give you 2 to the power of 8. Into 4 in the sense, if it is one part, to this if you add 3 parts, then only that becomes 4 parts. Yes. 1 part, 3 parts total will give you 4 parts. 1 part and 3 parts in the sense, what is the ratio? 1:3. 1:3, 25%, 75%. ఇవన్నీ 2కి పవర్స్ కదా 128 అను 512 ఎస్ ఆర్ నో ఇది కొంత యాడ్ చేసిన తర్వాత ఆఫ్టర్ యాడింగ్ సంథింగ్ ఇట్ బికమ్స్ 4 టైమ్స్ సో హౌ మెనీ టైమ్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ యాడెడ్ 3 టైమ్స్ యాడెడ్ బికమ్స్ 4 టైమ్స్ సో 384 అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 512 ఇన్ ద సెన్స్ 3/4 డైరెక్ట్ నీడ్ నాట్ టు గో ఫర్ ఎనీ సింగిల్ క్యాన్సిలేషన్ నాట్ ఈవెన్ విత్ 2 Right, any other question? 58. Number of male non-gazetted employees in company B and those in company D are equal. Non-gazetted employees, male, okay? If the ratio between female non-gazetted employees in B and those in D is 9:11, what is the total number of male non-gazetted employees in company B? Now, non-gazetted B and D, male are equal. So first of all, let me calculate how many non-gazetted employees are there. In B, non-gazetted female are given. Okay. Oh, male and female only. Non-gazetted, 150 here, 250 here. Male are equal. Respective ratio between female non-gazetted and those in company B and company D is given as 9:11. Non-gazetted only. 150 minus 6, 250 minus 6 is equal to 9/19. Okay. What is the number of male non-gazetted employees in company B? Difference 9 parts and 19 parts? Yes or no? How much is the difference? 10 parts. How much is the difference? 100. If 10 parts is equal to 100, then 9 parts is equal to 90. From 150, how much should be subtracted to make it 90? Matladru. X is equal to 60. Followed or not? Understood everybody? Sure. Next, any other question? Anybody? Sure?